Welcome to Power Electronics video series by Kemal. In this video, you will understand the construction of a thyristor SCR and you will recognize the behavior of a thyristor and its current voltage curve, and then you will be able to solve some circuits that contains thyristor. A thyristor is a three-terminal device. Those terminals are anode, cathode, and gate. Anode cathode terminals represent the switching terminals, while gate represents the control element that switch on the thyristor. As you know, diode consists of two layers, P and N layer, while transistors consist of three layers, either PNP or NPN. On the other hand side, the actual structure of an SCR, which is silicon controlled rectifier, or known as thyristor, it consists of four layers. Those layers are PNPN. The cathode is the most heavily doped layer. The gate and anode are the next heavily doped layer. The lowest doping level is within the central n-type layer. Let's understand the behavior of a thyristor in DC circuits. In this circuit, there are two switches. The first switch connects the main circuit to the supply. The second switch connects the gate to the supply in order to generate the trigger current. And there are two ammeters. The first ammeter measures the current that passes the thyristor. The second ammeter measures the current that passes the gate. Now, if we switch S1 alone and run the simulation, the current passing the thyristor is zero. And the reason why there is no current passing the thyristor is that the trigger current is zero. If we switch S2, still the current passing the thyristor is zero. Now, the reason why there is no current passing the thyristor, even though there is trigger current, according to the data sheet of this thyristor, the minimum trigger current that switch on this thyristor is 2 milliampere, while the current passing the gate here is 1.776 milliampere. To increase gate current, we reduce gate resistor. Applying Kirchhoff voltage low on this part of the circuit, I gate will be source voltage minus the drop voltage across gate cathode divided by R gate. Now, assuming that the drop voltage across gate cathode is given as 0.7 volt, then the gate current becomes 12 minus 0.7 divided by 2 kilo ohm. Find the thyristor current. We apply Kirchhoff voltage law on the main circuit. I thyristor is the source voltage minus the drop voltage across anode cathode divided by R load. Given to us, the drop voltage across this thyristor is 2 volt. The source voltage is 12 minus 2 divided by 10 ohm. Thyristor passes the current in one direction like diode, but in order for a thyristor to turn on, a current must pass the gate. So there are two conditions for the thyristor to conduct. Number one, it must be in the forward direction. Number two, gate current must be greater than minimum trigger current. Triggering a thyristor means switching on a thyristor. An interesting fact about a thyristor is that trigger signal can be removed and the thyristor stays on if its current is greater than latching current. In this circuit, the thyristor is on because we have a trigger signal at the gate. Removing the gate current, still the thyristor is on. According to the data sheet of this thyristor, the latching current is 10 milliampere. Latching current is the current that passes the thyristor at which the trigger signal can be removed and the thyristor stays on. Now, in this circuit, the trigger current cannot be removed because the thyristor current is below the latching current. Removing the gate current will turn off the thyristor. On the other hand side, the current passing the thyristor in this circuit is above the latching current, so trigger signal can be removed and thyristor stays on. We can keep increasing the load and the current will start decreasing. At certain current, the thyristor goes off. Holding current is the minimum current below which the thyristor goes off after it has been switched on. Let's have a look at the current voltage characteristics of a thyristor. In this region, the thyristor is off, while in this region, the thyristor is on. To move a thyristor from the off state to the on state, there are two ways. We either start increasing the voltage across the anode cathode until we arrive at the forward breakover voltage, and this is not desired because this might damage the load, or we may apply a gate trigger signal. Applying gate trigger signal moves the thyristor from the off state to the on state. at the latching current. This point is called the latching current, while this point here is called the holding current. When the thyristor is in the on state, there will be a drop voltage across the thyristor and can be obtained from the curve here. Applying a reverse voltage across the thyristor will cause a reverse leakage current to flow through the thyristor until the thyristor reaches reverse breakdown voltage. This might damage the thyristor.